Hey guys, welcome to a brand new video. Today I'm going to be going over my top 5 wilderness money making methods. So these will all be very high risk, high reward type methods, some of them getting up to 2 or 3 mil an hour, but of course you'll be risking quite a bit at that point. Most of these are going to be centered around combat, so you will need a relatively high combat level, so either high range or high melee combat skills. Alright guys, hope you enjoy, and let's get started. So coming in at number 5 is a pretty well-known one, but that's why I put it at number 5, and that is killing green dragons. Now this can get you up to about 400 to 500k an hour, depending on how efficient you're doing it, which is decent, and it's really not that risky. You're only in like level 15 to 17 wilderness, and you can teleport out, and people PKing there usually are not too good, so you can just run away either way. What you're going to want to bring is some cheap ranging or melee gear. I'm going to be ranging them just because I have a higher range level. You're just going to want to bring a glory plus some black dehide, as well as a rune crossbow, and most importantly an anti-dragon fire shield. Of course, if you have 55 slayer, broad bolts are very nice because they're very cost effective and you're not risking anything really to use them. It's always important before you go into wilderness to check your items left on death, so I'm going to be risking about 60k. If you wanted, you don't really have to bring the archer's helm, it's not really necessary, but you don't die too much here, so I'm going to bring it. I also like to bring a burning amulet because there's a teleport relatively close by that you can go to, which is just the bandit camp, and that's level 17 wilderness. Then I think you just have to run a little bit to the west from there. So from here, these dragons are just down here, so it's a pretty close teleport, and if you get into trouble, all you have to do is teleport out with a glory or a ring of wealth, but you might as well bring the glory because you're going to get the stat boost from that. Also, a ranging potion is important just to get those extra levels. So obviously, the higher your range level is, the more money per hour you're going to get, or the higher your combat stats. But you can see how quickly these things die. Like, they really don't even have that much health at all. I probably bought a little bit too much food, honestly. All you pick up is a green dragon hide and the dragon bones, and that's pretty much it. Ideally, you'd find a world with nobody in it, but it's pretty popular, so that may not happen. Now, you could bring an anti-fire potion or an extended anti-fire potion, but I have a decently high defense level, relatively, to these dragons at least, so I'm not going to take that much damage. It's not that big a deal. And also, it's very important to bring a looting bag, which I forgot, so don't do as I do as I say, or whatever that expression is. So this is just a nice entry-level method in the wilderness, so if you want to try killing things here, this is a nice way to do it. And yeah, let's move on to number 4. Now coming in at number 4 is going to be actually the Revenant Caves. Now the reason I'm putting this so low is because there are so many people there trying to kill you. So really, once this has been out a bit longer, it's going to be, I think, even more viable. But the money per hour here can vary quite a bit. I'd say minimum, if you don't get killed, you're going to get a mil an hour. So what you want to bring is the most cost-effective gear possible. You're going to want a blowpipe and some black dehide and a Amulet of Glory for the slim chance you'll be able to teleport out of there. Now, some people bring the Bracelet of Ethereum, which makes you invulnerable to the Revenants, but the likelihood of you dying is so high right now that I would recommend not doing it, because you lose it on death no matter what every single time, which is like a 70k loss pretty much if you charge it at all. So I'm really just bringing a full inventory of sharks to try to get away, Ranging Potion and a Stamina Potion to get there, as well as the Burning Amulet to teleport. Which you're going to want to go to the Lava Maze. Ideally, come here with someone with high range and a low combat level, because you will have a much higher chance of surviving. My main isn't the ideal level because anyone can attack me. So since I'm not bringing a Bracelet of Ethereum, you're going to want to focus on the weaker and lower level Revenants, because they're not too damaging, and really, you're going to want to teleport out as soon as you get anything relatively good, because someone will come and try to kill you right away. There's clans teleporting around all the time, just trying to kill people who look like me. So guys like the Revenant Imps are going to be one shots, easy to kill, and they can even drop actually Onyx Bolt Tips or stuff like that. And they're going to want to pick up all the Revenant Ether. That's actually somewhat valuable. And honestly, once you actually get into the cave, you're a little bit safer. Running there can be the highest chance of you dying, currently anyway. And it's really fun because even low level monsters like this are going to get you relatively good drops. And it's just really fun, actually. Surprisingly, I really don't like being in the wilderness and dying a lot, but I'm actually enjoying this quite a bit. All right, let's just check this drop quickly. And we got Revenant Aether times 6, which is like a K. Coming in number 3 is going to be killing lava dragons. Now, the potential profit here is less, but the potential for you to die is also quite a bit less. You may have noticed that I didn't even take a looting bag to Revenant Caves just because of how often you can die. However, I would recommend bringing it to Lava Dragons. Lava Dragons are most often killed with magic. A Trident of the Swamp is ideal, and I'm also bringing it a Rim's Top and Bottom, as well as finishing up the rest of my gear with kind of trash stuff. And I'm also bringing Rune Gloves just because they are not too valuable. As far as inventory, I'm just bringing some Monkfish, looting bag, games necklace, and some energy and stamina potions, as well as some runes to cast telekinetic grab, because I'm going to be killing it from the southern entrance. The reason I like doing that is because you have a much lower chance of dying. The problem here is that there is a Vedion or something in the way, which can get quite annoying, but honestly way less annoying than getting attacked by PKers all the time. So we're going to start off by teleporting to the Corporal Beast, and then we're going to run north to the southern entrance of the Lava Dragon Isle. So once you're out, you're just going to want to run north, and if we open up the map, it's actually relatively close. If you have the agility shortcut, great, but I do not have the agility level for that currently. However, it will be extremely useful for escaping any potential PKers. So the profit per hour of Lava Dragons can vary a bit, but you're going to get minimum 600k an hour, assuming you don't die too much. And you can get lucky and get upwards of maybe a mil an hour on some of your better runs. So around where the agility shortcut is a pretty easy place where you can aggro the dragons from. You have to keep in mind that you will need, of course, to telekinetic grab the loot after. But for the most part, if you can attack it, you will be able to grab the loot. So you can see how quickly the trident actually rips through the lava dragons. It's really nice. And these guys have a chance of dropping a draconic visage. They drop onyx bolt tips a lot. And okay, it's a dwarf. As well as some other decent consumable drops. And yeah, once you get the drop, all you have to do is cast... Oh, look at that. First drop, Onyx Bolt Tips, 100k. And we'll go ahead and pick up the rest of the stuff too. Another quick tip is actually if you bring a pestle mortar, you can actually turn the lava scales into ground lava scale or something, which will allow you to have a little bit more inventory space. And yeah, that's it, guys. A really fun method just because the drops are so good. There was a chance of getting PK'd, but it is much less down here. Most people are running in from inside the Dragon Isle. Coming in at number two is recharging Dragonstone Jewelry at the Fountain of Rune. Now this one is an extremely high risk, high reward method. The main reason is because you're carrying a ton of Amulets of Glory. Well, you can recharge Rings of Wealth are another good one, or you can even do skilled necklaces and stuff like that. Mainly those first two are the general ones people do. But you can see I'm risking 500k to go do this, but the margin on each one, let's see here. We bought them for 19.8k each, and we're going to sell them hopefully for about 21.2. So that's a 1.4k margin on each piece, and we can do like 26 per inventory, so it's about 36k per inventory charge. So let's go see how long it takes me to do this run. So things you will need is either 90 magic and access to the Anacarl teleport, or you just need to finish Ancient Magics and use an Anacarl teleport. Since I don't have 90 magic, I'm just going to use the teleport. It's not that big a deal. It'll be a little bit less money per hour, however. So to start, we're going to right-click and break the Anacarl teleport. I really appreciate this, not just a left-click activated ability, because that is extremely risky. It's going to teleport us to the Greater Demon section of the wilderness, very deep in the wildy. From here, we're just going to run to the west, and there's a little spit here that will actually go into where the Fountain of Rune is. And in the center, there is the, well, fountain that you can use your uncharged glories on to recharge them. Now, this is really the risky part here because you're really stuck in here. You do it all at once and you get a bunch of glories. Now, there also is a very rare chance of getting an eternal glory, which I don't know how much they're worth now, but it's tens and tens of mil. After you recharge them, you're going to run up north to where the obelisk is, and you're going to look for any area that's in less than level 30 wilderness, and you're going to teleport out with one of your glories. Okay, so we got level 27 wilderness, so you're just going to rub it and we teleport to Edgeville, and there we go, run complete. It took about a minute and a half. So every minute we're going to get about 24k, and in an hour we're getting about 1.5 mil. If you do runs in about 2 minutes, you're going to get closer to 1 mil. Really good method, but an extremely high risk method at that. And coming in at number one is exchanging ancient pieces for cash in the New Revenant Caves. Now, I did this on day one and got a ton of money, but I'm going to go test it out quickly just on, well, it's about a week later now. So we're getting about an 8k margin on the ancient emblem right now, and that's probably the one I'm going to end up doing, just because comparative to the other two ancient pieces, their margins are like 15k and 20k, but they are 2 and 4 times more expensive. So it's a really simple principle. There is the emblem trader in the Remnant Caves that will exchange emblems for 500k, 1 mil, and 2 mil respectively. The ancient emblem is 500k, the ancient totem is 1 mil, and the ancient statuette is 2 mil. Really just want to bring some defensive gear that doesn't weigh you down too much. I'm bringing the prayer potion because I'm going to be protecting an item, and on the very off chance someone tries to smite me or something, I don't know. I'll have a prayer potion, and it's not a huge loss otherwise. So we have a look at our items lost on death, risking about 36k, which is not too bad. One last thing you want to make sure you bring is a Dragonstone piece of jewelry, either a glory or a ring of wealth. It doesn't really matter too much. So we start off by teleporting to actually the bandit camp. And now the reason is we need to find the emblem trader, but we need him to be ideally in less than level 30 wilderness, because you want to be able to teleport out right away. This method is much safer if he's in level 30 wilderness or less, as opposed to having to run through the wilderness with like 2 mil cash for a little bit, which is not great at all. So once you're in a cave, you just have to run around and find him. It's a bit of a pain, but once you've located him, it's not nearly as bad, because you can power through this really quickly and run back extremely quick, and he doesn't have much time to move around locations so much. But finding him the first time can be a bit of a pain. So the clips here are pretty much from day one after the Revenant Caves were released, and I was getting really 6 to 7 mil per hour here. Now that it has died down a bit, and I went and checked the margins, if you're actually on it and doing about 50 to 60 runs an hour, which you can totally do if you know where the actual emblem trader is, you could still get close to 2 mil an hour. And if you take the time, and that's using the cheapest emblem, which you'll be getting an 8k margin on. Day one, I was getting a 40k margin on it. And if you went and bought the ancient statuette or something like that, you could get larger margins. However, the main drawback is, of course, the price of the ancient items. It would cost you in the range of 100 mil plus to have enough to do this for an hour with any of the more expensive items. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to toss it a like. Always appreciated. And I'll see you in the next video.